update to a story we broke just a few weeks ago. Let me remind you of the video. Here it is. There's now an update and more video. Before I go to the rest of the video, let's put up the picture of Mr. Anthony Franklin. See, his family has now filed a lawsuit. This is an update to a story about the police who shot and killed a 31-year-old black man after he fell to the ground. He appeared to be trying to get up on January 15th in Austin, Texas. In this yet unreported video, after Franklin falls off the marble railing, he curls into a fetal position and is shot by the police. Next, in a video that has not yet been reported on, Franklin can be seen throwing a gun into the gutter. He was unarmed. Here's the video. Okay, look very closely. Now, remember, at the heart of this case, the question was, did he pose a threat at the time he was killed by the police? Clearly, the video shows he did not pose imminent danger to the officers. This is the first time this video has been shown, period. There's more. The officer kept their guns drawn on this bleeding individual. He was dying right in front of them. He was surrendered. He was on the ground. Once again, here is the picture of Mr. Anthony Franklin. The attorney for Mr. Franklin, the attorney for the Franklin family, spoke directly to Indisputable. Here's Attorney Harry Daniels.
There was no reaching. There was no indication of firearms trying to be used. There's no and if you listen to one of the radio communication, the cop saying, "I'm taking incoming shots." Mm-hmm. No, he wasn't. He was shooting. We live in a country of laws, and at the end of the day, cop can be judged or executed. At the time that Mr. Franklin was shot and killed, it posed no immediate threat to law enforcement or the public. So therefore, it's unjustified. If we do not bring Mr. Franklin's story to light, if we do not pursue justice for it, the unlawful killing Mr. Franklin, guess what? You have more cases like Tyree Nichols. Because now, if the police can shoot you, regardless of what you've been accused of, then why we need a court system for? You can't be judged during execution. That's why we have a rule of law. That's why we have due process. That's why we have criminal courts. That's why we have criminal proceedings. Your job as law enforcement is to apprehend a suspect and bring him before the judicial officer, the court of law, to answer for the crimes.
This is why we have a constitution. And as I have said many times before, just because you may deserve to see a judge, it does not mean you deserve to see your maker. Cops are not judge, jury, and executioner. How did this get past many of you? There's a reason why many of you are unaware of this story. The Austin Police Department decided to release the body camera footage of this killing at the same exact time the video was released of the killing of Tyre Nichols. They did it to hide their issue of criminality in the fold of the world paying attention to another criminal mob. There's more. There's an excerpt from the Austin Police Department. The statement says, and I quote, the officers told Mr. Franklin, do not move. And he complied with those commands. Once officers gained compliance from Mr. Franklin, the officers approached Mr. Franklin, even though the gun was still within close proximity of Mr. Franklin. The officer secured Mr. Franklin and searched him for additional weapons. The officers immediately began life-saving measures. Now, Franklin family's attorney, they have filed a lawsuit complaining that the police had no right to shoot and that he was running away from the defendants. The Franklin family attorney, Harry M. Daniels, noted one of the officers asked another officer whether Franklin was reaching for his gun. Daniels said the police should never have fired if they were unsure of an imminent threat. That is absolutely correct. Let me show you the attorneys representing the family. Harry Daniels, Bakari Sellers, and Nathaniel Mack, all good friends. A representative of the attorney said media, they have not pointed out Franklin threw his gun away from him while guns were still drawn at the prone suspect on the ground. Here are Franklin's three daughters. Please understand, when things like this happen, you don't simply kill a person. You kill hope. You kill relationship. You kill guidance. You kill mentorship. Daniel spoke to Indisputable. He played a part in his daughter's lives, he said. It doesn't matter how old you are, when you lose a child, it's still your baby. A GoFundMe link has been set up for the Franklin family. We've raised $2,300 since Indisputable first posted the link. We can definitely do better than that. I encourage you, go to Justice for Anthony Marquis Franklin when you get a moment. We have the rest of the video. I want you to think about the extremes these cops went through to hide what they did. Even by manipulating when the video came out so that you as an audience would not pay attention. But we do pay attention. We expect more to come. After this reporting, we will bring you the updates as they develop. Odessa has the thoughts here.
I'm not sure what more it's going to take for people to realize the epidemic of police brutality and using lethal force in the United States. Reaching for your pockets is not a crime. Carrying a weapon also isn't supposed to be a crime in the United States. And Harry Daniels, the attorney, put it really well when he said, we can't have the police being judged during an executioner. What is the judicial system for? Law enforcement is supposed to apprehend people who are accused. And then we have due process of law to determine whether or not they've actually committed a crime. And then the punishment comes after that. And then you have folks still defending the police saying, well, you've got to comply. Where's the freedom in our country? If a police officer can stop you for no reason, and unless you do everything they say as they say it, they'll use lethal force. And even still, they'll use lethal force when you've absolutely done nothing wrong. That's why people run from the police, is because they have killed people who don't even pose a threat to them. It's a survival response. Even the police know that what they do time and again by shooting unarmed black men, they know it's wrong because they try and hide it. They manipulate the release of the footage so that at times with the Tyre Nichols shooting in the media, so people don't pay attention to what happened in Austin. They know it's wrong. We're going to need more people to realize that this is wrong because it can't keep happening like this. People aren't paying attention to it to the extent that's needed for laws to change and for us to change how we keep people safe in public in this country.
Very well said.